Hello, my name is Heber Barbero, and today I'd like to talk about web work. This is a series of videos that I'm preparing for instructors. I have another video on YouTube that shows web work from a student's perspective, but now I'm going to do this series of videos to show instructors how to run a course using web work. What you're seeing is the main page of the web work server, which can be accessed here at this site, blackfordstadler.wedu. And once you get here, you will have an account that I will create for you. For example, I created this 6321 just now for a colleague. And so you can click on this and then you'll have a user number as an instructor. So the user number for this session for me is user 2, and the password. Okay, before I hit continue, I want to show you this disclaimer that could you please later on come back and read? That is important. So I click continue and then I'm in. Here I have another disclaimer in case the students do not read the previous one. It's also important. Please be aware of what it says here. So now we look at the page for Composite Material Design, which is this course, CT321. And okay, so what we like to do now is we would like to start assigning homework to the students. So to assign homework to the student, we go to the left side. So this left tree, it has a lot of things that in time you will learn to use and will appreciate because they are very useful. The site is very user-friendly and it's very powerful. So, but for now, we just want to create homework one and assign it to the students so that the students can start working. For that, what we do is we go to library browser. So the way we do a homework is similar to the way you would do with a paper book. You go to the end of the back of the chapter and look for problems that you can assign to the students. That's the same thing. So we go to the library browser to see what problems we can assign. So that's the library browser. Now in the library browser, we have to, if we haven't created any homework, or started any homework, then we have to create a new one. So I'm going to create a new one. I'm going to call it homework one, just like that. You can put whatever name you want. And then you must click this button. If you don't click this button, then you're not creating a new homework. Once you create a new homework, it will appear here. And if we have many, they all will appear here, but we have only one. So we're going to work on homework one. Now we need the problems. The problems, we're going to find them in local problems. That is, this is going to show you problems that are on the server and that I have those problems I have loaded for you ahead of time. So, okay, among local problems, we have to select which collection we want to look at. Now, in this case, the problems that I loaded are the problems that go with the book Introduction to Composite Material Design, third edition. And essentially, I have here, or you will have here, almost virtually all the problems that are in the back of chapters 1 to 7. Also, I have put these problems twice. I have a set from chapter 1 to 7 that is in the folder chapters not random, and then the same set in chapters random. So the random problems will assign different values to different students. This is good for a large section because then the students, it makes it more difficult for the students to copy. At least they have to find somebody that did the problem on paper with their numbers, and then they have to plug in a different set of numbers, so at least they do something. Okay, so I use this a lot when I teach large courses where there is possibility for cheating. But if you're teaching an online class, it's a little bit difficult if everybody's calling you over the phone or chat and everybody has different numbers. So if the class is small and the probability of cheating is low, Then I prefer not to use random, but I use from this set that is not random. That means it's like old school type of homework where everybody gets the same numbers. So today we're going to assign from here, from chapter not random. So, okay, I pick chapter non-random and nothing happens until I click view problems. So now, okay, here we go. We have the problems for chapter one not random. And here is there is a statement of the problem. You see here it says what the problem is. This is very similar to the problems in the back of the chapters in the book. There may be a slight variations to make it to adapt the problem for online delivery, but not much. All right, so then I read this problem and I decide that, this is the statement. This is the answers I expect from the students. And then I say, okay, I want to assign this problem, so I'm going to assign this problem. So to assign the problem, what I have to do is click here. All right, click here, and that's it. That problem is assigned. Then I go down and I find a second problem. Here there is this link that says show path, which actually shows you the file name of that problem. The problem is ICMD, which means Introduction to Composite Material Design, chapter one, problem two. So that's exactly like in the book. And I say, okay, this is a nice problem. Yes, I expect the student to calculate the thickness. Fine, I'd like to assign this problem. So I assign this problem. And then I think, but maybe I can assign some problem from chapter two, because I mean, as long as we have covered something in class about chapter two. So I go to chapter two. And then once I go to chapter two, I have to click view problems again. And I can see the problems, yes. And so I have this problem, which is very easy. And I got this problem. Okay, maybe I can assign this problem. So I add this problem. All right, so now we have three problems assigned. And I think that's enough for today. And what can we do now? We can go to homework sets. And in homework set, we see there is a homework one. Click on homework one. And yeah, it has three problems. I can look at the problems again, and this is what the students will see. They will see problem one, 1 point. Oh, I forgot to assign how many points I want to give as credit for each problem, but we can do that later, no problem. So, okay, so we have this problem, which is the 1-1 in the book, ICMD 1-1 in the book, and here's the statement. And here is a place for the students to enter the answer. One thing that is different from your view and the student view is that the students will not have this link solution. As an instructor, you can find out right now what the solution is. If you click here, the system will tell you what the solution is for this particular set of numbers that are given here. The students will not see this. The students, the only thing they can do is they can check that the units are correct, check that it's well formatted, then they have to submit. Once they submit, if the problem is wrong, the system will tell them. And if I allow multiple attempts, then they can try again. And you can decide how many attempts you want to allow. It's totally up to you. It can be done in another part of this system. All right, so that's for the first problem. And so then I see next. And, here's the second problem. Again, I have the solution. And then next, problem three, here is the third problem. And, so everything is fine. So now what we have to do is we have to change this 1 point. We want to assign more than 1 point per problem. And also we have to set the due date and things like that. So in order to do that, we go now to homework set editor. Right here. So homework set editor, because we have a set, which is homework one. Right now we're looking at problem three, but we want to go here to homework set editor. So when we are in the homework set editor, what we see here is a list of all the homework. Right now we have only one homework. And there are a number of columns with information that we would like to adjust. Okay. So for example, here we see, homework one, there are three problems. The assigned users are one. Since you created the problem, then you have it assigned to you, but the other four students do not have it assigned, yes? Now, you don't want to assign it until you are sure that you're happy with this homework, because once you assign it, the students will see it and start working on it. And then if you want to make changes, it's a little bit of a problem. It can be done, but let's say you delete a problem and the student already have done that problem, then he's not going to feel so good about it. You can add more problems. That's really not a problem. You can add more problems and they will have to do it by the due date. But in this case, okay, let's say we're happy. We know this homework is great. So we can click here in the one in this link that says how many students are assigned. And then we click here, and you can see here that admin two, this 956 and Asmus, they don't have this assigned. The only one that has this assigned is me, because I'm doing the problem. But since I'm sure that I want to assign this to everybody, okay, I click here and I can assign it, all right? Now, you could unassign, but unassign is dangerous because when you unassign, whatever work the student did is going to be lost. So that's something that it's better not to do. Right now, everybody has this problem assigned to them, all right? And then that's it, okay? So so now that we have this done, everybody has the problem, we go to homework set editor again, and then we see here there is a open date and reduce scoring date and due date and answer date, and we have to edit, we have to change these dates, okay? So in order to do that, we click on this pencil, and then, okay, now we can say, do you want to do, you want to give reduce scoring? So reduce scoring, what reduce scoring means is that there is a date when you want the students to see the homework. If you don't want the students to see the homework now, then you put a future date. If you want to see the homework right now, then you click on now here, done. Right now, all students are seeing this homework. Now the computer picks a date for reduced scoring date, and then later, the due date. After the due date, the computer will not give any credit for a student if they do it after the due date. After the reduced scoring date, it will give a percentage, which right now I have set up at 50%, but you can set up to whatever you want. Okay, so that means that there is a date, which right now is like the 29th, 7 days from now. And if they do it after that, they get only 50%. And then there is another date on the 12/6, December 6th, which is will be like another week. And that's the true due date. Basically, after that, zero. They don't get anything. And then there is the answer date, 2 days later. You can put whatever date you want. And by then, the students can see the answer. Like, if they didn't get the answer correctly, at that time, the system will let them see the answer. All right? So right now, what I want to do is enable reduce scoring. If you don't click here, there is no reduce scoring. Leave the dates the way they are, and then take action, because if you don't click this, then nothing that you do here, it will take effect. So you take action, and that's it. All right, so the only thing that we haven't done is to assign how many points per problem. And for that, we click a pencil again. Then you see homework one is a link. So we click on this link. First, we see this information repeated, which is when it opens, reduce scoring, due date, answers available. Is it visible to students? Yes. Reduce scoring is enabled? Yes. You can change things here, and it has the same effect as in the table that we have seen before. So for now, we just leave it like that, okay? I always do that, everything on the table, okay? So now here we see the problems, okay? Here are the three problems that we assign. So one of the things that we can do here is to reshuffle the problems. Like if I want three to be before two, I click on this move and I drag the problem, but I'm not gonna do it now. The other thing I can do is I can say, no, I want to delete this problem. So I mark it and I go down here and I save changes. But today I don't wanna delete anything, so I'm just gonna go and click it. If you don't click save changes, nothing happens, okay? The fact that it's clicked, marked there doesn't mean anything. You click here, then you save changes, it's going to delete it. But I don't want to delete it, okay? So then as far as the point is concerned, okay, we can say, all right, 10, 10, 10, all right? And then, of course, save changes. So everything has 10 points, yes? But then maybe I doubt that, I'm not sure if it's fair to give 10 points for all the problems. Everyone is 10 points. So, but I don't remember exactly how difficult the problems were. So one thing I can do is I can render the problems. Click here. You see, here's the problem again. So now I read this problem and I say, no, this problem is a little bit heavy. So I think it's worth 20 points. I change it to 20. And the next one, no, the next one is easy. 10 is fine. And the last one is super easy. So 10 is fine. So save changes. Did it take? Yes, 20, 10, 10. So we got everything. We got the points for the problems. We got the dates. And it is assigned. If I want to check if it's assigned, just go here and I say, yeah, I have 5 in the class, the instructor and 4 students or something like that. And they all have it, so it's ready. They can do this, all right? So once we are there, then basically we're done. The students can start working on their homework. And so if I go here, that's my homework 1, and I click there. And here it says, after the review scoring period, all work counts for 75% of its value. Ah, no, I forgot. I set it to 75%. It can be changed. One thing I want to do before we quit is I would like to download a PDF of the homework statement. I don't need a PDF because the students don't need a PDF because they will be able to see it online on the computer, on their phone. It works very well on the phone. But I would like to have a copy on a PDF in case the server crash. I have my copy of the homework statement. And sometimes it's easier to go there and just look at the PDF. So to do a PDF, there is this link here. I just click on it. I choose what homework I want to print. I want to print homework 1. For whom? Since you are an instructor, you can choose to print whoever's homework you want, but in this case, it's going to pick me, user 2. And then I go down here, and select what I want to print. Student answer, no, I want to see correct answers. And then generate the copy. And that's it. I have a PDF. And you can see it's a PDF on paper. Okay, so that's it. Thank you.